Well, Carol, police have been to this house before, and they're very familiar with both suspects. Now, tonight, investigators left this small white house you see behind me with several bags of evidence from inside the house. They also left with bags of evidence from outside the house. What appeared to be a big bat or stick, and that could be a key piece of evidence in this case. Franklin police and deputies from the Warren County Sheriff's Office began arriving just before 5. They had a search warrant in hand. They were gathering evidence for a second time at this house on Vernon Street. It was a search that would last for several hours. They left well after dark. It's this house where they believe 16-year-old Deion Payne was beaten nearly to death. Police say it was a drug deal that turned violent, and 36-year-old Michael Geldrich and 39-year-old Michael Watson are the ones responsible.
You didn't have to go that far, and they went far. And I mean, it's senseless.
A friend of the victim's family spoke to 9 on Your Side outside of Franklin courtroom where the suspects made a video court appearance. In that courtroom Tuesday afternoon, the victim's mother openly cried, at one point leaving the courtroom to compose herself. Her emotions raw, knowing she was there to see the man police say attacked her son before dumping him at a hospital and leaving. 16-year-old Deion Payne would only live one day after that attack. Donna Persons believes race played a role in the incident.
It's been going on and on and on for ages. Stop it. Stop it. Leave us alone and let us live.
Judge Rupert Ruppert told the suspects, Michael Geldrich and Michael Watson, they faced aggravated robbery and aggravated murder charges and could face the death penalty for the crimes. And Persons says they should die for killing Deion Payne. She says he didn't have to die.
This is a 16-year-old against two grown, fully grown men, big men. What could he possibly stand to lose? I mean, all you had to do is if it was something that you wanted, you robbed him, you got it. Now leave him alone. Let him live.
Now, Franklin's police chief tells us he will talk to us about this case tomorrow. We hope to get new information on the case then. Now, as for the suspects, they are locked up in the Warren County Jail on a $1 million bond. They'll be back in court on December 10th. Reporting live in Franklin, Natasha Williams, 9 on Your Side.